If you're a gamer like me, God, I hate saying that, you probably know about Hollow Knight. A challenging Metroidvania with intricate maps and mechanics by an indie dev of 3 people. Loved by fans and critics alike. You might even be waiting for the sequel, like I am. I didn't used to be into 2D platformer old-looking games. Like, what is Metroidvania? What is Metroid? What is Castlevania? I don't know. My games before Hollow Knight consists of Titanfall, Call of Duty, Battlefield, FIFA. That's a lie for a joke, I never played FIFA. So, it was to my surprise that I actually enjoyed niche, does this count as a niche? Niche titles like Hollow Knight. I get into more gaming, pulling up hardcore games like Dark Souls, Devil May Cry, Doom, Animal Crossing. That's a lie for a joke, I never played Animal Crossing yet. But the more I play, the more I realize games like this are like a needle in the haystack. Most AAA games follow a set rule. Play the same, and while the first experience is exhilarating, when you've played 50 titles, it gets stale. So, I scoured into the indie landscape, where I found Hollow Knight. And still, like the AAA counterpart, it's a bit of hit or miss. More so the fact that there are more indie games out there than there is AAA. Only some good, mostly bad. Like in the Steam new releases. But usually, if an indie is so good, or usually innovative, it will be picked up by a lot of content creators. That's how I found Tunic, Outer Wilds, and Before Your Eyes. So, it's baffling to me that there is barely any talk about this little game called Pronti. There, that's the name of the game. That's what you've been waiting for this entire video. You can go check it out now, or you can still listen to me ramble. But don't worry, I will not spoil anything. As I grew my scope wider, I found games I wouldn't have touched before to be interesting. Hooked by the flashy art style, I put them on my wishlist, sitting there for years in hopes that I will eventually play them. On one occasional day, I found this game called Pronti. It looked cute and stunning, so I put it on my wishlist, never to see the light of day again. At least until the past few months ago. I had a lot of time on my hand, even a lot more games on my wishlist. I'm always turned off by the big titles like Metal Gear Solid and Xenoblade, which I haven't played. I know, it's not exactly because I don't like them, quite the contrary. I know I will like them, which is why it seemed unappealing to me to play them. Because I would also know what I will get. So I looked towards the indie titles. A few caught my eye. Hades, Blue Fire, Pronti, I could go on and on. Again, some games I know I will like, some I've heard about, and most are unheard of. And that's where Pronti comes in. As of writing this script, it has a very positive review of around 400. Not 1000, just the 100. As a sucker for underrated title like this, you know where this is going. Pronti is an indie game Metroidvania, released back in November 2021. You play as, you guessed it, Pronti, and will traverse the deep, trying to bring peace along with your trusty partner slash javelin, Bront. It took me around 20 hours to finish, and it was fun. It's no platformer like Hollow Knight, because, you know, it's underwater, unshackled from the Y-axis. There is a badge system, like Hollow Knight, There is also a stamina system for dodging, so you cannot spam dodge. Also, bench, or bonfire, or however you may call it. But weirdly, no penalty for dying. Weirdly again, there is a difficulty option that you can freely tweak. And I mean freely. Most games inspired by Hollow Knight would opt away from this option. The attacking system is also more towards Ori and the Blind Forest instead, along with the blocking mechanic. It seemed challenging at first, but it's pretty easy to get used to. There are more lovely design decisions, like a bonfire or teleport right beside boss's room. Enemies are also unique, with each having its own behaviors. On the other side, there are some weird decisions, like money isn't really that important. Sometimes you have to buy badges, but other than that, I don't find much use for them. Also, the boss enemy design is also a bit of hit or miss, as in attack pattern, not the art design. It doesn't grow progressively harder. Some bosses in the earlier game I found hard, while the later ones can be easy. But most of them don't leave enough windows to heal. Also, unlike Hollow Knight, which feels to have a very dynamically alive-feeling world, with many NPCs doing their own stuff, this game has so few NPCs, even fewer that change along with progress. A lot of world building and lore was also done in collection type logs, which I dislike. The story is also feels like it was made to be family friendly. There is blood, mind you, just the way it was built was simple. There is no darkness eating away at the world nor madness invading the residence. On the other hand, actual voice acting.
Mina, darling.
Like real words, not
Yolo no Tugobis
or
oh, Tanchatsura
or whatever language Hollow Knight is. The soundtrack is a bop. The art style is also hand-drawn, which is always welcomed. So yeah, in the end, I liked it. So why haven't I heard of this game before? It's released in November 2021. That's more than a year ago. And it only has this many reviews on Steam. That's just sad. Haiku the Robot, which came much later, is now sitting at a higher number of reviews. Not playing down on Haiku, mind you, it's just an example. It's even sadder that the fact that it's a Metroidvania, which means that there are just some cases where I wouldn't be able to figure something out and has to go to the internet and there's nothing on the internet, but I finished the game. There is no point about ranting about the past. I could've just gone ahead and finished the wiki, write some guide on the obscure things, the stuff that hinders me from progressing, share my journey. But instead, I take a look at the game's background.
No need to thank me.
Pronti is released back in November of 2021. And you know what they say? The peak of a game's player count is when the game is released, which is consistent with Pronti's Steam charts. The first day of Pronti's release is the most player it's ever seen. Of course, there are several cases where this isn't true, like in popular games such as Hollow Knight, Ender Lilies, Hades, where the game could see a peak weeks or even months after its release. But for the most games, even AAA titles, this graph is to be expected. Still, although graph-wise it made sense, number-wise, it's disheartening. A game is expected to do well in its first week because it's also expected to have a lifespan in which the player count will diminish and die out, in which the game no longer makes much profit. It's reasonable to expect many games, and I mean many, including the big titles, to predict how much it will do in its first moments to calculate prospective profits and losses. Not content with what I found, I went deeper into the developer and publisher, or developers. and publishers. That's weird, I thought. Why does a small game have more than one developer and even more publishers? If it's a big game, I can understand multiple studios involved, since it's easier to outsource the work, divide it, put a reasonable deadline, and then once everyone's work is done, it's just a matter of combining them together. The downside of this is that it's very hard to change your idea or vision down the line, or even if something doesn't work in one department, since you have to go out of your way to tell everyone else to change something so it stays compatible with each other. This is why indie games are indie, independent. Starts with one studio and stays that way. This way, the game's vision is fluid with how the developers want the game to be, not with the plan they had from the beginning. Anyway, I went on the tangent. And don't take this as a fact. I'm just stating what I think I know, which isn't much. So this might be a special case. But still, I look into them. The developers are 18 Light Game Limited and Funzone Games. A quick Google search of 18 Light Game quickly shows the studio's information, including its official website. And that's weird, I thought. I mean, it could be malware bytes is just detecting a false positive. But anyway, I proceeded to the site and quickly regretted that I put this script on hold. I used to be able to open the site, but now it looks like this. The site is dead? Why is the copyright only until 2020? Does that mean the archive is that old then? I refreshed the page to see the live web. Should have figured that one out. I tried using a VPN, but it doesn't seem to work anyway. Back to zero. I went back to Google and found an interesting clue. They have apps on Google Play. I checked that and found out that they've made a game for Android. Nothing too unusual. Every developer can make games for different platforms however they want. Clicking on it, I found what type of game it is, which is quite a 180 from Pronti. I found the dev contacts, which said that they are located in Taiwan. I didn't find any more important information, so I moved on. They have a Twitter, if you realize. They seem to be pretty hard on their game Pronti. Scrolling down, you can see their latest tweet is from August. I can see this as they don't use Twitter so much, and that might be true. They hardly post there, and it seems there is no clear schedule. Sure, we can get that by. But you should know there is something huge happening in Taiwan in August. I can only pray that what I feared is untrue. We should dial back down before this becomes a political topic. I went to their Discord and luckily found out that they are still active dealing with bugs, with the latest report around September. Their latest message, however, is later in September, helping a fellow gamer. Quite nice to see. But that's all I can find about them. Let's move on to the next developer, Funzone Games. The only real page from here is the Steam Store and Gematsu, both of which don't have any useful information other than they develop one game, Pronti. The other Funzone Games, because of how ordinary that name is, doesn't feel like they have anything to do with Pronti. Looking into the publishers, boy oh boy, there are 4 publishers of the game. I know of some games that, despite having another publisher, would still has the studio's name in the publisher's list. So I think I don't have to talk about 18 Light Game anymore. CE Asia actually has a good background, publishing 5 games and has their hands in the development of one game, Laser League. They seem to be legit, been around for 2 decades. A bit of scouring and I actually found out that they are in fact the most legit so far. They have a site that is maintained with English language built in so I don't have to use a translator. What's more is that they have associations with huge titles that you could ever think of. Their store is exactly that, if you wanna check that out. Joybrick Inc. is also very legitimate. Although they only have this amount of games on Steam, they do get their hands dirty developing their games, Panzer Knights and Jerez Arena. Don't look that one up. They also have a mobile game. On top of that, they also have their own website. Sadly, their site has no built-in English, so I have to navigate with a translator. On their site, they have more titles that they show off, even some that are still in development. Joybrick seem to have more in hand with development of the games. Though, as a publishing company like CE Asia, they have a deeper background in the distribution side of things. JB Shop, which they have, also had a lot of merch from big names. Lastly, Mayflower Entertainment, which doesn't have its own Steam page. Even more worrying is that their site is insecure, as in they don't have an updated certificate. Other than that, if the site is to be trusted, it shows the big title it's working with as well. From our research, we can see that there is only one hole to be questioned, which came from the developer side. I mean, I don't do intensive research, and Funzone Games might be legitimate, but from what little that I get, it does seem fishy. Pun intended. I think the problem is with the publishing side of the game. Not as in the publishers, but in the act of publishing itself. Namely, marketing. It's easy to point fingers at someone, but I don't know how it really works in the industry. You can argue that a select some publishers care so much about their games, so the ones that don't are really frowned upon. But what if that's the agreement they came with the devs? That is a possibility, no? Of the fact that the devs only need them as a distributor, so that they can have as much leverage in making the game they want without the publishers butting in on their work. Still, that argument from before must also be acknowledged. There is a possibility also for the publishers to just not care about small titles, especially if they're as huge as our subjects. When you have that many projects, you wouldn't be able to give them all your undivided attention. You would focus on the ones that you know will make money, so you can burn some on the ones that don't. Sadly, this will obviously result in the ones who won't make any money actually not making any money. And that is why I don't know who's at fault. It could be anyone. It could be the developers who don't want any help. It could be the publishers who don't give enough care.
It could be you. It could be me. It could even...
But I feel like I get the idea of how it could happen. Lack of marketing. It always saddens me to see a game definitely full of potential that has little to no recognition. If you've been in this field as long as I do, I'm sure you understand what I mean. And this isn't limited to only games. But we all can only do what we do best. Talk. Chat about it. Tell the world about what we love about it. Annoy other people to play the game and be obnoxious about it in the internet. And that is why I'm here, talking about this game. If Pronti, after all that description, resonates with you, do please give it a try. Especially since there is still time till Silksong.